Welcome everyone. I'm so glad that we are again meeting on our 8th video on DBMS. This particular topic is on joints on relations. I am Payal Bhattacharji, PGD Computer Science from Kendra Vidyalaya No. 1, Kachrapada. आप सभी का हार्दिक स्वागत है. रिमेंबर वन थिंग दैट लर्निंग इज अ नेवर एंडिंग प्रोसेस, सो कीप लर्निंग. एज यू नो दैट वी आर कवरिंग डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट फॉर 12 कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड आईपी एज यूनिट 3 एंड यूनिट 2 रिस्पेक्टिवली एज पर द सीबीएसई करिकुलम 2020-21. The contents which we are going to cover today is concept of joints on relations. These are the learning outcomes which we'll see at the end of this video. We'll learn types of join, in that inner join, outer join. The outer join are again of three types: left join, right join, full join, and then cross join or Cartesian product. Equijoin, natural join, non-equijoin, and then some additional search conditions in joints. And as you know, due to this outbreak of COVID-19 pandemic, the syllabus has been revised by CBSC, and in the syllabus they have included the concept of joints, and in that they have included cross join, Cartesian product, equi join, and natural join. So let's move on. Concept of joints and relations. So all these we'll be covering practically. I'll show you each and everything. Remember, MySQL queries are not case sensitive, so keep it in your mind. Let's move on. Before I start on with joints, let me tell you about qualified names for fields. What are qualified names? Qualifying a particular column name uniquely identifies it from similar columns in other tables. Qualified field names are very useful in identifying a field if the two joining tables have fields with same name. If the tables do not have same name for the columns, then using table names as qualifiers in the select statement, that is optional. For example, if you have two tables, subject and teacher. Now here subject number is a common column in both the tables, subject as well as teacher. Then in that case, when you are trying to join these two tables, there might be some conflict, since sub_no subject number column is present in both the tables. So you have to mention table name, any of the table name dot that column name, column name or the field name which has the same name in both the tables. So remember, qualified name usually we use with those which have a common name in both the tables in a database. So this is what qualified name is, and you will learn it when we'll go through the examples. Now the next one is alias name. Alias names for tables. You've already learned column aliases, which are used to make column heading in our result set, and helps it makes the query very easy to understand. For example, you must remember the query which we have done earlier in our earlier videos. Also, I have said, like, to calculate the annual salary. Suppose in a table there is only salary column, monthly salary, and you need to calculate the annual salary. Then what you do? You do salary into 12, and you give a name to that particular column, salary into 12. Suppose in quotes you have mentioned annual salary. Now that is the column alias. Now what is table alias? Table aliases are used to shorten a SQL query, and it makes it easier to read. Suppose there are long names of tables, then you have to mention, you can mention, it's not compulsory, but you can mention a short name to the tables. In the from clause, see this example, from employee. Now suppose employee and department, these are the two tables. So E is a table alias giving, we are giving for employee, and D is a table alias we are giving for department. So in the where condition, when we are using, you can write like this: employee.dptno equal to department.dptno. Instead of writing big names for the tables, you can use this alias names: e.dptno equal to d.dptno. So remember that alias names, they makes a query shorten and makes the query very easier to read. Now let's move on. Concept of joins on relations. Now what is a join? A join is actually a query that combines rows from two or more tables. There is an exception. Before we carry on with this, there a single table can be joined with itself, self join, but we are not going into the details of that. So join is what? Join is a query that combines rows from two or more tables. In a join query, more than one table are written in the from clause. So we can say that joining is the function of combining data from multiple tables or multiple relations, and join condition expression with where clause is the join predicate. For example, this one. Join condition you will mention here in the where clause, so that becomes the join predicate. Select, you have to mention the field list, from, mention the name of the tables using comma separation, and then where clause, that is optional, and you have to mention the join condition. Join condition is a must in case of join queries. So let us see the different types of joins, and with example we will understand each and everything. Let me give you a concept of one type of join, a cross join. See here, there are, so let me explain you this in Hindi. मान लेते हैं कि पहले टेबल में हमारे पास राइस है और रोटी है, और हमारे पास दूसरे टेबल में दाल मखानी, पनीर और चिकन है. अब क्या कम्बिनेशन हो सकता है? कम्बिनेशन कैन बी राइस विद दाल, राइस विद पनीर, राइस विद चिकन, और अनदर कम्बिनेशन विच कैन बी राइस विद रोटी विद दाल, रोटी विथ पनीर, रोटी विथ चिकन. सो फर्स्ट टेबल प्लस द सेकेंड टेबल इक्वल टू, यू गेट दीज ऑल कम्बिनेशंस बाय जॉइनिंग दीज टू टेबल्स. आफ्टर जॉइनिंग दिस टेबल, टेबल वन, एंड टेबल टू, यू गेट टेबल थ्री. So table 3 has got all the combinations, right? So this is what your join condition is. Let's move on. This is basically an example of cross join, which we will see later. Now let's move on with the next part, that is types of join. So inner join, outer join, cross join, natural join, equi join and non equi join. We'll learn one by one each. Outer join again is of three types: left outer join, or we say that as left join, full outer join or full join, right outer join or right join. So let's learn one by one. Before we move on, let me tell you that here in this entire video I've taken example of these three tables which I have created. The three tables: subject, teacher and Salke. So we will work with these three tables. See the MySQL prompt where I have created in the CSIP database itself. Select stuff from subject. This is the subject table. This is the teacher table with TNO, T name, SAL, subject number. Subject number is common in both the tables. Subject underscore NO is the primary key of subject table, which is a foreign key in teacher's table. Now see, these two have the same name as well as the values. And notice one thing, except one, intentionally I have not given any teacher out of these five teachers, Rohan, Sachin, Naina, Priyanka, Ayan, I have not given one subject number to anyone. That means no one teaches English over here. And the third table, SAL grade, which we will be needing later on, that is, we will use this in case of non-equijoin, that I will show you later. So first of all, we will work with these two tables mainly. So there are three rows in subject table. Three records: one, English ENG; two, Hindi HIN; and three, Maths ENG as medium. And there are five rows in case of teacher table. So you have to keep this in your mind. And there are four columns. Now let's see. Let's start from inner join. Inner join, what it does, it creates a new result table by combining column values of two tables. Let table 1 and table 2, two tables are there. On the basis of the join condition, the join predicate, the query will compare each row of table 1 with each row of table 2, and wherever it gets a pair, it gets a satisfactory result for the condition, it will give you the output. So inner join is basically an intersection of table 1 and table 2. Wherever it is getting, it is comparing and it is getting a pair of rows which satisfy the join predicate or join condition, that will be in the output. So let's see how inner join is written. So I have run this in MySQL prompt. Select asterisk from subject inner join teacher. Subject first table, inner join is the keyword, teacher is the second table. So we are inner joining these two tables, and the condition is where teacher dot sub underscore NO equal to subject dot sub underscore NO. This is the join predicate. The where condition is the join condition or the join predicate. Now see what you are getting in the output of the inner join. You are getting the columns, all the columns of subject table. You are getting all the columns of teacher table as well. And wherever it is getting a common match, subject number, sub underscore NO, it is getting a common match, it is displaying you the rows there. See, just now I said that one I have not given to any teacher intentionally in teacher table to see how the inner join is working. Yes, inner join is working perfectly because one is not there, right? Same way we can write here teacher inner join subject, that also you can do, and condition you can write any way. The left hand side of the equal to can be written at the right hand side. Like if I write subject dot sub underscore NO equal to teacher dot sub underscore NO, that is also correct. And if I write subject dot sub underscore NO equal to teacher dot sub underscore NO, that is also correct. But remember, in the qualified name, this portion, or we can say this portion, always before the dot operator, table name will be there, dot, and then the column name. So both of these are showing the same output, only that when you are writing teacher inner join subject, the column of the teacher's table, it is showing first in the beginning, and then the columns of the subject table. and see sub underscore NO, which is a common column, it is showing twice. Yes, it will show all the columns. Now let's move on. Outer join. The outer join is very interesting. Outer join are of three types. In the outer join, all content of both the tables are integrated together. Either they are matched, either they are not matched. So matched as well as unmatched. If they are unmatched, then null value will be given. Just now we have seen in case of inner join where there was no matching, it was not showing any answer. But in case of outer join, you will see if there is no match, it will give you the value null there. Right? So let's see. And another thing which is very important, that on keyword. Now this time instead of where, you will see on keyword, which is used in the join predicate of outer join. Now types of outer joins. So let us see them in details. First of all, left outer join, or we can say left join. It returns all the rows. See this diagram. Returns all the rows from the left table combined with the matching rows of the right table. So this portion is the matching row portion. This portion is which is not matching. And if you get no matching in the right table, it returns null values. Now right outer join or right join, it returns all the rows from the right table. It will return all the rows from the right table combined with the matching rows of the left table. Now this one. And if you get no column matching in the left table, it returns null values for this. And full outer join is what? You are combining both. Result of combination of both left and right outer join. So it's a combination of this and this. That means it's a combination of this and combination of these two queries. So result of combination of both left join and right join. And the join tables have all the records from both the tables, and it puts null on the place of match is not found. Wherever the match is not found, it will place null. So it's actually a union of these two, this one and this one. These two are queries, left join query and the right join query, and full outer join is the union of left join and right join. Let us see with example. Now see, I have given the table also. So this is subject table, this is teacher's table. Now if we do left join, so in the query I have written subject at the left hand side in the from clause. So select star from subject, left join teacher. So subject, all the columns of the subject table will come first and then all the columns of the teacher table. This is very clear in case of left join. Whoever whose name you are writing at the left side of this join keyword, left join keyword, will come first. Now the condition is you have to mention on instead of where, the on predicate is used. Teacher dot sub underscore no equal to subject dot sub underscore no. Now, this is the join predicate, this is the join condition, wherever subject number is matching. So let's see wherever the subject number is matching. So since you have written subject in the first, so one English ENG, it is not getting any value. Please notice over here, it is not getting any value over here for English. So that is why it is returning a null value for the first row, for first English, which is there in the one English ENG, which is there in the subject table. Now see, for the second one Hindi, it is getting value for Rohan, and then again two Hindi for Priyanka, again three Maths, Sachin, Naina and Ayan, like this. So wherever it is not getting any match in the right side table, it is giving null value. In the same way, now the teacher's table is at the left hand side. See the query, teacher left join subject. So teacher, all the rows of the teacher table will come first and all the columns also. Now after that, subject table, for the subject table which is there at the right hand side, it will see whether it has got any match or not. Yes, 2 is there, so it will write the value for 2. 3 is so for 3 it will write 3, all the values 3, maths, ENG. Again for Naina, 75003, now it has got a match with the subject table also, 3 maths, ENG. So it is getting a match. See, left join में, left side में जो भी table है, उसके सारे values यहाँ पे आपको लिखने हैं. और subject जो right side में जो table है, उसके जो भी table इस values के साथ, ये common column जो condition आपने दिया है, ये on के साथ जो condition आपने दिया है, इसके साथ जो भी matching उसको मिल रहा है, उनके values वो लिख डालने हैं इस साइड पे. इसलिए यहाँ पे आपको नल वैल्यू नहीं मिला, लेकिन पिछले वाले में, पिछले क्वेरी में जब हमने सब्जेक्ट को लेफ्ट साइड लिया था और टीचर को राइट साइड, तब हमने सब्जेक्ट सारे लिख दिए थे, लेकिन सब्जेक्ट वन इंग्लिश ईएनजी जिसको हमने लेफ्ट साइड लिखा था, उसका कोई भी मैचिंग नहीं था राइट टेबल में. राइट टेबल कौन सा था? टीचर टेबल. क्योंकि उसका कोई भी मैच नहीं था, इसलिए यहाँ पे नल आ गया वैल्यू. और जहाँ पे उसको मैच मिले, टू हिंदी हिंद, तो टू के लिए रोहन का था, प्रियंका का था, और थ्री वैल्यूज के लिए मैथ्स सचिन, नैना और अयन, तीनों का ही था. होपफुली आपको समझ में आ गया होगा लेफ्ट जॉइन. नाउ लेट्स सी राइट जॉइन. नाउ इन केस ऑफ राइट जॉइन, इन द सेम वे यू हैव टू राइट टीचर राइट जॉइन सब्जेक्ट. नाउ व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग दिस, सो टीचर विल बी एट द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड एंड राइट जॉइन, जो भी राइट में है उसके वैल्यूज पहले लिखने हैं, उसको पहले हमको इम्पोर्टेंस देना है, ये समझिए. तो वन इंग्लिश ईएनजी, इसका क्योंकि ये वाला वैल्यू है सब्जेक्ट टेबल में जो हमारे राइट साइड में है, अब हमारा राइट टेबल ज़्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट है. वन इंग्लिश ईएनजी, उसके सारे वैल्यूज लेने हैं आपको, लेकिन वन इंग्लिश ईएनजी का कोई भी मैच हमारे ये लेफ्ट वाले जो टेबल है, टीचर टेबल इस केस में, उसमें नहीं है, इसीलिए नल आ गया यहाँ पे. इन द फर्स्ट रो यू हैव गॉट नल, एंड फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ द वैल्यूज सब्जेक्ट टेबल में यू हैव गॉट अ मैच इन द टीचर टेबल, इसीलिए आपके टीचर टेबल के सारे वैल्यूज आपको सब्जेक्ट टीचर सब्जेक्ट के वैल्यूज के साथ आपको मैच मिल गए. यानी राइट वाले राइट जॉइन में राइट वाला टेबल हमको सारा वैल्यू लिखना है उसका, जिसका मैच नहीं मिला उसके लिए नल लिख देना है लेफ्ट साइड में. यहाँ पे हमारा राइट जॉइन में राइट टेबल इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, दैट इज सीन फर्स्ट. सिमिलरली राइट जॉइन इन दिस केस वेयर टीचर इज एट द राइट हैंड साइड, तो पहले हम राइट वाला देखेंगे, टीचर टेबल को राइट साइड में लिखेंगे, उसके सारे वैल्यूज लिख दिए. अब लेफ्ट साइड में देखिए सब्जेक्ट, क्या हमें मैच मिलता है? रोहन, रोहन का सब्जेक्ट नंबर है 2, और हाँ 2 हमें सब्जेक्ट टेबल में भी मिलता है, इसीलिए 2 हिंदी हिंद हमें यहाँ लिख दिया. सिमिलरली सचिन, जिसका सब्जेक्ट नंबर है 3, यस यू हैव गॉट अ मैच इन सब्जेक्ट टेबल, सो यू हैव गॉट दिस वैल्यू 3 मैथ्स ईएनजी. सिमिलरली नैना हु हैज गॉट सब्जेक्ट नंबर 3, यू हैव गॉट अ मैच. सिमिलरली फॉर प्रियंका हु हैज गॉट सब्जेक्ट नंबर 2 एंड अयन हु हैज गॉट सब्जेक्ट नंबर 3, यू हैव गॉट अ मैच इन द सब्जेक्ट टेबल, सो दैट्स व्हाई यू हैव रिटन. अगर कोई मैच नहीं मिलता तो नल आ जाता, जो कि पिछले वाले में था. होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड लेफ्ट जॉइन एंड राइट जॉइन. एंड फुल जॉइन, दो इट इज नॉट इन द सिलेबस, बट स्टिल आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट इन केस ऑफ फुल आउटर जॉइन, फुल आउटर जॉइन इज एक्चुअली यूनियन ऑपरेटर, यू हैव टू यूज द यूनियन कीवर्ड विच विल डू द यूनियन बिटवीन द लेफ्ट जॉइन क्वेरी एंड द राइट जॉइन क्वेरी. प्लीज नोटिस दैट दिस इज द लेफ्ट जॉइन क्वेरी, दिस वन लेफ्ट जॉइन क्वेरी, दिस एंटायर थिंग, and this query is on the right join. So left join and right join, in dono query ka select star from teacher left join subject on this condition, union select star from teacher right join subject on condition. So these two joins, left join and right join, you are uniting, union karne se wo sare values aapko mil jayenge, aur jahan pe null hai wo null aa jayega. This is your full outer join or full join. Now moving on. Cross join or Cartesian product or unrestricted join. So what is a cross join? Cross join is used to return the Cartesian product of two tables, or we can say unrestricted join also, or we can say cross join also, the same thing. So Cartesian product of both the tables, it gives all possible concatenations, all possible combinations of all the rows of both the tables. Yani table A ke 1 ko उन्होंने टेबल बी के 1, 2, 3 सबके साथ मैच किया, फिर टेबल ए के 2 को उसने टेबल बी के 1, 2, 3 सबके साथ मैच, सिमिलरली टेबल ए के 3 को इट इज़ मैच विद टेबल बीज 1, 2, 3, सो ऑल द रोज आर मैचिंग विद ऑल द रोज. नो फिल्टर कंडीशन इज स्पेसिफाइड इन द क्वेरी, दैट इम्प्लाइज द जॉइन इज अनरेस्ट्रिक्टेड. इज नो रेस्ट्रिक्शन, देर इज नो रेस्ट्रिक्शन, इट इज अनरेस्ट्रिक्टेड जॉइन, एवरी वन इज जॉइनिंग विद एवरी वन. As you have seen in the case of that rice and roti combination, rice roti combination जो था उसमें जैसा हमने देखा था, क्या देखा था कि हर एक रिकॉर्ड, अगर इसको हम पहला टेबल ले, हर एक रिकॉर्ड, यहाँ पे 2 रिकॉर्ड है और यहाँ पे 3 रिकॉर्ड है, दाल, पनीर और चिकन. ये पहला टेबल है ग्रीन वाला और ये रेड वाला दूसरा टेबल है. सो every row is matching with all the rows of the second table. Rice you are matching with dal, paneer and then chicken, this one, and then again roti you are matching with dal, paneer and chicken. So you've got this one. So on total you are getting 6 combinations. Why you are getting 6 combination, please understand, since there are 2 rows in the first table and 3 rows in the second table, so 2 into 3 equal to 6. So the output table, the resultant table which you are writing at the right hand side of the equal to which you are getting, it has got 6 combinations. So this is what cross join is. So let's see now that the syntax, let's see how we write the Cartesian product or the cross join syntax. Select list from table 1 comma table 2. For example, select asterisk from subject comma teacher. In the same way, cross join, using this cross join keyword also you can write like select list from table 1 cross join table 2. Example is select asterisk from subject cross join teacher. But remember, which is very important, on clause is not at all used in cross join. Among all the other joins, only this on clause you will never write with cross join, because if you mention any on clause, which is the condition, that will make it some other join. So since this is unrestricted, you cannot give any restriction to this join. On clause will provide a restriction ki subject number match karna chahiye subject table ka aur teacher table ka subject number ke saath. To koi restriction yahan pe kyunki dena nahi hai, isiliye there is no on clause in case of cross join. So let's move on with this. So let's see what you get. So when you write select star from subject cross join teacher, so you get this output. How? All the columns of both the tables, the same column will be repeated and the number of rows, that is the cardinality, will be the number of rows in the first table into the number of rows in the second table. The first table subject table comprised of 3 records, just now you have seen, and teacher table comprised of 5 records. So 3 into 5 you get 15. So that's why the output table, the cross join, the Cartesian product table has got 15 rows, and column is the degree, number of columns, so that will be summed up, added. Degree of table 1, subject number, subject name, medium, 3 columns, and teacher table has got 4 columns, TNO, TNM, SAL and subject number. So 3 plus 4, 7 columns are there. So hope you have understood. So this point is extremely important. For Cartesian product of table 1 and table 2, the resultant table's cardinality equal to cardinality of table 1 into cardinality of table 2, and the resultant table's degree equal to degree of table 1 plus degree of table 2. Hope you have understood. Cross join. So let's move on, and remember there is no join conditions, there is no restriction at all. Another way of This one I have shown. Subject table, teacher table, 5 records, so 3 into 5, 15. Just to show you. And degree, 3 columns plus 4 columns makes 7 columns in the output. So let's move on with the next part. Equi-join. What is equi-join? Equi-join is basically based on a condition which you give on the basis of equality. It is compared. The two tables are compared in which columns are compared for equality. And this join combines the tables based on matching values in specified columns in the join condition. In the join condition, see here in the example, select asterisk from subject comma teacher, two tables you have given, where subject dot sub underscore no. Now this is the qualified name for sub underscore no from the subject table, and this is the qualified name for sub underscore no from the teacher's table, teacher dot sub underscore no. When you are writing equal to here, this means this is an equi-join condition. So which is an equi-join condition? When you are mentioning equal to, so this one we have an equi-join condition. You can write this entire part at the left hand side and this entire part at the right hand side of the equality operator. That will fetch you the same answer. But the thing is, you have to remember that table name comes first and dot common column name. So equi-join based on equality. So let's see. Equi-join example. Select star from teacher, subject, where. Now this is the equi-join condition we have given. Teacher dot sub underscore no equal to subject dot sub underscore no. See, the common column is coming twice. Sub underscore no is here also. In the entire query, sub underscore no is coming twice. This column is coming twice. Similarly, if you are writing subject comma teacher, and in the where condition, if you are mentioning subject dot sub underscore no equal to teacher dot sub underscore no, still you will get the same output, only that the subject columns are coming first, since in the from clause you have mentioned subject. So sub underscore no, sub underscore name and medium. Again, teacher table, TNO, TNAME, SAL and sub underscore no again. So remember that the common column comes twice in case of equi-join condition. Now what is the difference between equi-join and natural join, which is our next topic? And the difference is natural join, in which only one of the identical columns, that is the common column coming from both the join tables, exists. Only once the common identical column is coming. So a natural join is a type of equi-join only, where the join predicate arises implicitly by comparing all columns in both tables that have the same column name. But the thing is, only the common column will come once. I will show you the example first. See here, select asterisk from teacher and you are writing natural join subject. Teacher, natural join is the keyword, subject. So where, now the join condition, equi-join condition you are giving here also. Subject underscore no, this is the common column which is coming only once. Similarly, when you are writing teacher natural join subject without any condition, without any where condition, then also you are getting the same output, but the subject number is also coming once. So these two are absolutely same. Now let us see what are the different ways of writing natural join. So natural join syntaxes are given this side. So we can write like select table 1 dot column list and table 2 dot column list without the identical column, and from table 1 table 2 where the condition. Or we can write select star from table 1 natural join table 2, or we can write select star from table 1 natural join table 2 where we can give the condition also, the common column condition, the equi-join condition. Or we can write in this way also, select column list from table 1 join table 2 using. Now using is another keyword which we use with natural join for any query. To make it a natural join query, you can use this keyword using, and you have to just mention the common column. Let's see the examples one by one. Select teacher dot asterisk. Now what does this mean, teacher dot asterisk? That means teacher table ke sare column. Teacher dot asterisk means all the columns of the teacher table, comma, subject table. So we don't need sub underscore no, since teacher dot asterisk is covering sub underscore no, this common column. So we are just writing sub underscore name, subject name and medium from the subject table. From mention the two tables, where mention the equijoin condition. Again select star from teacher natural join subject. No need to mention anywhere condition, by the keyword natural join it will do the natural joining. Select star from teacher natural join subject, where again give the equijoin condition. Select star from subject join teacher. Don't write natural here, because you are mentioning using keyword which will mention the common column name, and by this it will understand that you are equalizing on the basis of this subject underscore no column, and then it will give you the output of natural join only. Hope you have understood. Just now we have seen this example also of natural join, so I have just shown it here. Those with using, you're getting the same query, subject underscore no, the common field is coming once here also in the same way, teacher dot start, so all the columns of the teacher table, and then comma sub underscore name, subject name, comma medium, and from teacher join subject, like this. So hope you have understood natural join as well. Let's move on to the last one, that is non-equijoin. A non-equijoin is a query that specifies some relationship other than equality between the columns. So there won't be any equality condition here in case of non-equijoin. No equal to operator. Now how we will do that? Let's see. See here. Now taking the example of teacher table and sal grade table. Select star from teacher comma sal grade, where sal between low sal and high sal. Now low sal and high sal are the two columns from the sal grade table, right? And since you have given star, so it will show you all the columns of both the tables. Right, and see, there is no common column between these two tables. There is no common column. So how you are joining these two tables using this non-equijoin condition? How we are writing in, see the where clause, where I have written sal between low sal and high sal. Now this sal grade, this particular table is made for grading the employees on the basis of their salary. If the salary is between 80,001 and 1 lakh, the grade will be A, and 70,001 and 80,000, the grade will be B, like that. So let's see what are the grades the employees gets in the teacher table. So according to their salary, they are placed, since it is in between this, so it is getting grade C. 80,000 Sachin, since this is in between this, so it is getting grade B. Again 75,000, which comes in grade B. Again 70,000, it comes in grade C, like that. Ayan 70,000, it comes in grade C. So there is no equality operator or equijoin condition. This is just non-equijoin condition, where you are joining the two tables on the basis of non-equijoin predicate, non-equijoin condition. So finally we have understood all the join queries and all the join concepts. So hope you will practice everything in MySQL prompt as well, and I'll share the all the queries in notepad. You will get it in my blog, nopythonbytes.blogspot.com, and you can practice all these things. Lastly, additional search conditions in join. This one, another query, final additional search conditions. How we can write s dot subject underscore no, sub underscore name, t name sal, from subject and subject s, teacher t. Here we are using the table alias S and T for subject table and T for teacher table. S dot sub underscore NO equal to T dot sub underscore NO. Now this is the join condition. And with the join condition, you are writing AND SAL greater than 70,000, another condition. And then you are using order by also, order by T name. So it is fetching you all the records who have got salary greater than 70,000. And it is ordering by T name, means in ascending order by default. So Naina, N comes first and then comes S. So it is ordering by T name in ascending order of their name alphabetically. And it is showing what? It is showing S dot sub underscore NO, subject number, subject name, T name and cell, which you have written in the select clause. See, so many things we have used in this. We have used the table alias, we have used the join condition, equi-join condition, and then we have used some other condition as well, SAL greater than 70,000, which we can do. So if you want to give any other condition other than the join condition in the where clause, you have to use AND, because join condition to hona hi hai, it is a must thing. Uske saath AND karke baki conditions likhne hai. And then agar order by hota hai tumhare question mein, to you have to give that. So this is what, let me show you another, the same thing, table alias SMT, and this is the join condition on sub underscore NO, and this is your nested order by. Nested order by means order by sub underscore NO, phir again you have to order it by SAL. So pehle subject number wise yahan pe ordering kiya gaya hai, yani 2 or 3 sabhi teachers mein, ya to koi सब्जेक्ट नंबर 2 से है या सब्जेक्ट नंबर 3 के हैं, तो जितने भी 2 वाले हैं वो सबसे पहले, क्योंकि असेंडिंग ऑर्डर में है, और 3 वाले उसके बाद नीचे. अब 2 वाले के अंदर भी अगर हम देखें सैलरी, सैलरी अगेन इट हैज बीन ऑर्डर्ड विद इन दिस. सो फर्स्ट दिस वन, फर्स्ट द ऑर्डरिंग इज डन इन दिस वे, दैट इज फर्स्ट द 2 वाले एंड देन द 3 वाले. एंड देन अगेन ऑर्डरिंग 2 वालों के अंदर, 2 सब्जेक्ट नंबर के अंदर अगेन यू हैव ऑर्डर्ड 60,000 एंड देन 70,000. अगेन 3 वालों के अंदर भी असेंडिंग ऑर्डर में सैलरी को किया गया है 70,000, 75,000 एंड 80,000. सो दिस इज व्हाट नेस्टेड ऑर्डरिंग इज, ऑर्डर बाई में एक ऑर्डर के अंदर फिर दूसरा ऑर्डरिंग, सॉर्टिंग, एक सॉर्टिंग के अंदर दूसरा सॉर्टिंग. सो फाइनली वी आर एंडिंग दिस topic and hope you all will practice from the all the queries which I have given here. Sometimes we are tested not to show our weaknesses but to discover our strengths. So keep your hopes high, keep practicing, don't lose your hope, stay safe, stay aware, stay healthy and stay alert. Thank you for your patient hearing. Thank you so much.